Hello and welcome back to another electronic circuit review. For this Darlington circuit, we are going to determine the value of current I. As we can see here, the current I is the same as the current flowing through the collector of transistor Q1. So if we find the current flowing through the base of transistor Q1, then since the beta is given, we can simply calculate the current I. In this type of circuit, when we have a voltage divider with other components in the base of the transistor, it is a good practice to find the Thevenin equivalent of the biasing circuit from the base terminal, because it helps to simplify the circuit and provides accurate results. Here in this circuit, resistors R1 and R2 with a combination of diodes D1 and D2 and Q3 are providing the biasing for the base of the transistor Q1. With a closer look at D1 and Q3 and how they are connected, we can see that the base emitter junction of transistor Q3 is basically acting as an additional diode because its collector is connected to its base terminal with D1. And this wheel provides a forward bias to the base emitter junction of Q3. So essentially, we will have three diodes which are connected in series with R2. Here is the simplified circuit seen from the base of Q1. And we need to disconnect this part from the rest of the circuit because we want to find the Thevenin equivalent. As you may notice, we modeled D1, D2, and the base emitter junction of transistor Q3 with a voltage source with potential difference equal to 3 times of VD, which is about 2.1 volts. The Thevenin equivalent will consist of a voltage equivalent, VTH, and a resistance equivalent, RTH. For the resistance equivalent RTH, we short-circuit all the voltage sources seen from the point we would like to find the Thevenin equivalent. In this case, both VCC and 3VD will be shorted, and here is what we will see. To find the voltage equivalent VTH, we should keep the voltage sources in the circuit and then we calculate the current flowing from the VCC to the ground. For simplicity, let's call this current ID. Now, with knowing the current, we can simply calculate the VTH as follows. Since base of the transistor Q1 is disconnected, in order to find the Thevenin equivalent, so there won't be any IB flowing through the base of the transistor Q1. An ID can be determined by So we will have let's plug the voltage and resistance equivalents in the circuit and find an expression for IB1. Before we continue, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Your support will help this channel to grow and encourage me to create more content. Thank you, and now back to the video. With writing a KVL Kirchhoff voltage law from base of Q1 to base of Q2 and the emitter and RE, we can determine the IB1. However, we need to make sure that we are counting for the current gain beta for both transistors. Let's proceed with the KVL. Let's call this expression 1. IE2 is the current flowing in the emitter of the transistor Q2. The relationship between IE2 and IB1 is let's call this 2. By plugging the voltage and resistor values and combining and rearranging the expression 1 and 2, we get And IB1 can be calculated from this expression. And finally, we can determine I from now we found current I. How about you calculating the current flowing through the collector of transistor Q2? Write your answer under the comment. If you enjoyed watching this video and found this channel helpful, please like, subscribe, and share your thoughts under the comments. Thank you for your support. See you at the next video.